You're in tune to 710 Radio, iHeart Radio, Rosemary's World of Cannabis. You know how I do each day. Hey, we got to give you that public service announcement, and we're going to be back with no other than the doctor, Dr. DB Kush.
Are you feeling like a shadow of yourself? Is your mood on its way down? You could be suffering from low THC, also known as cannabinoid deficiency, caused by 77 years of government interference via prohibition. Do you live in a medical cannabis state or the District of Columbia? Are you over the age of 18 and seeking non-toxic natural health, well-being, and peace of mind? Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. After 10,000 years of recorded human use and 77 years of failed prohibition on the world's most extensively tested plant, the results are in. Cannabis has no known lethal dose and is arguably the safest and most comprehensive therapeutic substance known to man. Cannabis remained in the United States pharmacopoeia until 1941, and cannabinoids are currently patented by the federal government as an anti-inflammatory, U.S. patent 6630507. Human brains have cannabinoid receptors. Cannabinoids are lubricants in the human body. Due to prohibition, our bodies have been denied essential lubrication. Imagine never changing or adding to the oil in your car. The use of cannabis for low THC may cause immediate relief, including a general feeling of well-being, chronic smiling or laughing, feelings of euphoria, increased creativity or clarity, a greater appreciation for music and art, the desire to dance, increased feelings of inspiration, compassion or unity, a need for truth and justice, or you may wake feeling more well-rested than usual. It's undetermined to know exactly how many symptoms the use of cannabis may alleviate because of federal prohibition. There were dozens identified in the 1909 Eli Lilly Pharmaceutical Handbook. Currently, over 80% of the population supports the right to use cannabis therapeutically, and 92% of its users have declared significant non-toxic relief. The most common side effects, which are usually mild to moderate and may fade or disappear completely over time, are dry mouth and drowsiness. Other more serious side effects can include growing and repairing brain cells and DNA, or improve vision, may prevent Alzheimer's, dementia, glaucoma, nausea, and suicide, may provide relief from autism, asthma, anorexia, arthritis, AIDS, cancer, Crohn's, depression, epilepsy, fibromyalgia, gout, IBS, insomnia, MS, migraine, pain, Parkinson's, PTSD, and spasticity. Use caution while driving or doing other physical activities until you know how cannabis affects you. May cause paranoia or nervousness, specifically caused by real-life government intervention in your quest for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness in the USA. Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. Brought to you as a public service announcement by the People's Plant, a campaign of conscience.
And we're back. We got 11 minutes after the hour. You're in tune to 710 Radio, iHeart Radio, Rosemary's World of Cannabis. And y'all won't believe who I got on the radio today. It be the doctor, Dr. DB Kush.
What's up? How y'all doing?
Hey, doctor, we be doing good. Hey, it feel good. Hey, this like old times, man. Sit up there talking to you one-on-one, you know, just me and you hanging out for a minute. Hey, while I got the doctor on today, guys, for one, it's nice to be back on the mic with Dr. Kush, and two, Dr. Kush got some big things he wants to share with us today. Doctor, the mic is all yours.
What's up, y'all, man? Just chilling. You know, I'm out here in the mile high. I got the joint going around, smoking up the room like we do. You know what I'm saying? Medicating, recreating. You know, the SOS movement is brutal for all people out there that might know me. You know, we're on MTV True Life. My parents love their weed. And, you know, from that, it's been pretty dope. It's most watched, most shared, most commented in the last 15 years, you know what I'm saying? So, I guess we did something that was interesting enough to go. We smashed numbers for 15 years. But the bigger part is everybody knows, you know, we've been pushing the Kush Light. For the family oriented side of this marijuana industry. It's looking like some of this is coming together. We're about to be on a documentary series that's out of Denver that starts from the marijuana culture mixed in with the fashion and the music, and you get a chance to see me and my daughter back in action.
Oh, wow. That is real nice. Wow. Y'all, hey, when y'all bring that show back on the road, y'all gonna have to come out here and see me then, man. Where y'all can come and see what we be doing out this way.
Well, you know, I mean, all I need to do is start to promote it that way, and I'll come that way because, you know, next weekend we out there in Vegas. I'm hosting Crime-A-Con Vegas.
Oh, that's huge.
One of the hosts. So we're going to be hitting Vegas next Friday through the weekend. So if you're in Vegas out there and you tuned in, you know, come to Alexis Park, see if you can play bong pong with Ken Olympics, you know, holler at your boy, like SOS, smoke one, son.
And smoke one, son, exactly. But, yeah, I mean, I'm really excited. I was surprised you went out there in Vegas because it started at midnight this morning that Vegas was able to sell cannabis recreationally.
I know, but, you know, I wasn't there physically, right? But virtually, I was there.
I feel you.
This is what I mean.
I feel you.
For the last 2 to 3 weeks and last month, you remember the footage playlist from when we went legal here that they just keep playing everywhere?
Mm-hmm.
That's what was running on News 3 in Las Vegas.
I thought so. I was like,
we smoking and talking. Every time I look up, you know, we invaded another state's news channel. So we invaded Vegas' news channels, and they was playing me talking about medicating and recreating. So, you know, they got a taste of who I was. They got to meet me through the news, the show.
Yeah, wow. It's crazy. I mean, all of us in our own way, you know, done, you know, after MTV, we all went our separate ways one way or the other, but we all stayed in touch and we all stayed in the movement one way or the other, and that's what's so crazy. Yeah. I mean, you're doing, you know, Kush Life, and then you're doing Can Olympics, and you're doing, I mean, you're doing a lot, Doctor. I mean, wow. I mean, you just keep it going. I mean, and then...
Another thing I want people to check out, right?
Uh-huh.
Is on the internet, there's an internet movie that I also shot like a year and a half ago. It's called Cloud Gang.
Oh, you didn't shoot that? Okay. What, yeah, say the name of that again?
Cloud Games.
Cloud Games. Okay, I'm going to have to check that out.
And Games is spelled G-A-M-E-Z.
Okay.
Cloud Games.
Okay.
But, you know, you see the Catalytic, you see the Catalytic trays in the movie, the papers. You see me getting high, talking stuff on the scene. And you hear my voice as the radio voice on the movie.
Oh, wow. That is too cool. Wow. Hey, you is keeping it up. Yeah, man, that is...
You know, me and the TV is trying to be friends.
Hey, it sounds like the same thing that's going on here. I just did another XS 21 here in out of Charlotte, and they should be airing that tonight, matter of fact, Saturday night. They're going to be airing that with Dr. Honeycutt and Shamika. And then also, they got this podcast called 704 PPC Poppin' Podcast, where we did a 30-minute with Chill Girl of 105.3 out of Charlotte, North Carolina. They just aired that this week. So the girl been staying busy. Hey, I'm trying to keep up with you, Doctor, but you're making it a little hard, man.
Well,
I'm
about to, you know, the one making, we all making, you know, we're going to pull everybody through.
That's it. And I think it, and we, I mean, how we've been tag teaming, you know, across the country one way or the other, you know, we're both saying the same thing, you know. Hey, we got to get this thing done medically, period. I mean, medically, recreationally, you know, everybody says here, we don't want to be another Colorado. I'm disappointed that you don't want to be another Colorado. And I'm going to tell you reasons why. From what I've seen, and I know the doctor is going to elaborate on it even more, with the growth that y'all have there in Colorado as far as jobs, industry, and everything else, I mean, why not you want to be like Colorado?
Well, yeah, you know, I was just having this explanation to a guy that said, I wish all the out of time was just to be. I said, hold on. Let's think about this, what you're saying. I said, marijuana industry in Colorado is struggling. But that didn't just happen. What happened was barbers moved here, real estate agents moved here, airline people moved here. All those people brought heavily in their economic growth. And each of those industries that had nothing to do with weed, you can name any industry, it was also impacted by the weed boom because now their businesses are getting more customers. And it had nothing to do with them buying a bag of weed. It's because I needed my hair done. It's because my car has to get fixed. Because I got to rent a place. So before you know it, every industry in Colorado exploded because of this industry growing up.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what I'm trying to get people to understand, because that's how it works. I mean, people need to know and understand that. People need to understand that's how it works. Hey, Kush, we're going to take a quick commercial break, okay?
All ready, bada bang, bada boom.
All right, we'll be right back with you. Rosemary's World of Cannabis.
Are you feeling like a shadow of yourself? Is your mood on its way down? You could be suffering from low THC, also known as cannabinoid deficiency, caused by 77 years of government interference via prohibition. Do you live in a medical cannabis state or the District of Columbia? Are you over the age of 18 and seeking non-toxic natural health, well-being, and peace of mind? Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. After 10,000 years of recorded human use and 77 years of failed prohibition on the world's most extensively tested plant, the results are in. Cannabis has no known lethal dose and is arguably the safest and most comprehensive therapeutic substance known to man. Cannabis remained in the United States pharmacopoeia until 1941, and cannabinoids are currently patented by the federal government as an anti-inflammatory. U.S. Patent 6630507. Human brains have cannabinoid receptors. Cannabinoids are lubricants in the human body. Due to prohibition, our bodies have been denied essential lubrication. Imagine never changing or adding to the oil in your car. The use of cannabis for low THC may cause immediate relief, including a general feeling of well-being, chronic smiling or laughing, feelings of euphoria, increased creativity or clarity, a greater appreciation for music and art, the desire to dance, increased feelings of inspiration, compassion or unity, a need for truth and justice, or you may wake feeling more well-rested than usual. It's undetermined to know exactly how many symptoms the use of cannabis may alleviate because of federal prohibition. There were dozens identified in the 1909 Eli Lilly Pharmaceutical Handbook. Currently, over 80% of the population supports the right to use cannabis therapeutically, and 92% of its users have declared significant non-toxic relief. The most common side effects, which are usually mild to moderate and may fade or disappear completely over time, are dry mouth and drowsiness. Other more serious side effects can include growing and repairing brain cells and DNA, or improve vision, may prevent Alzheimer's, dementia, glaucoma, nausea, and suicide, may provide relief from autism, asthma, anorexia, arthritis, AIDS, cancer, Crohn's, depression, epilepsy, fibromyalgia, gout, IBS, insomnia, MS, migraine, pain, Parkinson's, PTSD, and spasticity. Use caution while driving or doing other physical activities until you know how cannabis affects you. May cause paranoia or nervousness, specifically caused by real-life government intervention in your quest for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness in the USA. Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. Brought to you as a public service announcement by The People's Plant, a campaign of conscience.
And we're back. Sorry about the interruption, guys, but sometimes you got to go to that break because you have to go to that break. We still got DB Kush. Kush, I hated to interrupt you, man. You remember what we were talking about? I don't.
Yeah. We were just ending off on the cloud dance. Make sure y'all check that out. Smoke season. And then we started talking about, you know, the economic growth in Colorado.
That is correct.
Because of the marijuana industry. And it also has a lot of people, even like yourself, that came here and got to learn a lot of the game in the early phases and be able to take that knowledge back to your town.
Exactly. I mean, when I said my name was Miss Green Jeans, it stuck, because the point is this, that was no joke. That was not a plug. That was because a lot of stuff I didn't know. And since I've been from Colorado, you know, I've been continuing doing my education and research and my activism, and I just kept growing with it, going across the country, spreading that message that cannabis is real and cannabis is safe, saves lives. And now that we've done all that, we got a chance to even go out to D.C. We done been up to North Carolina. Now we're finna go to Atlanta. And, I mean, as long as I got breath in my body, I'm going to speak about this wonderful plant. And I thank you, DB, you and everybody else there in Denver, that showed me a lot. I mean, it was a lot more to it than just lighting up and rolling up. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly, because a lot of people think that, oh, that's just weed, man. They're just getting high. No, that's a benefit to this plant. This plant is a wonderful thing. And when you get to know it, you always want to have it. And, you know, they look out there because, you know, being urban and being in this industry and getting in the industry when I did, which was very, very long ago, you know, it wasn't a lot of urban people in this fight. You know what I'm saying? So, of course, police come into your house for some bull. You had to go through the whole rigor mortis stuff because black people thought if you had a red card, you was going to jail.
Yep.
And here I am with my red card and plants. And they were, oh, they're going to take you to jail for sure. Yep. But over the first 2-3 years of One Boy Radio talking and moving around, people started getting them cards. Before you know it, the urban neighborhood was full of red cards. I feel like it's just people like me to just step out and just be very open and out with it. Like, you ain't got no card, fool.
I mean, and it's sad. We always be the last to everything. And this is, I mean, we're criminalized more than any other. We're the smallest denomination, but we're criminalized for it more than any other nationality in the United States. Because, like, for instance, right, in Colorado, y'all have 10% of the African-American community. But I can guarantee you 50% of y'all get locked up for it.
No, nobody get locked up for
it. Yeah, they're getting locked up for it right now. I mean, they're going in, busting in people's houses with these grows and stuff. If you got over one plant, they can come in and take all your plants.
Yeah, but if you look at, like, the last big indictment they had, you just seen one black person in all 62 people indicted. The brothers don't even really caught up in that.
Okay.
The weed indictments out here, you on your hands,
trying to have any blessings inside of it. But yeah, we still so far behind, though. I mean, how many, you know, think about it, in the Denver area alone, you only got one grower and dispensary owner. One.
Yeah.
That number still is not right. We're not even close.
We talk about that regularly, you know, disparity and how the regulations and things are omitted.
Yeah.
So therefore, the ways that they're able to keep you out of that side of the industry.
Mm-hmm. And it starts with the legislation, and people don't realize that if you don't go up there to whatever state you're in and go to the state house and sit down and listen and fight for your rights. I mean, yeah, they passed the bill, sure enough, but that's a constant fight no matter what state you're in. Perfect example, the state of Florida right now. State of Florida is in one of the biggest dog fights it is with medical cannabis. Now, check this out now, Fred. This is going to make you laugh. You know you can get locked up for smoking cannabis in Florida, but if you smoke, if you're vaping and have a medical card, you don't get locked up? Now, what sense does that make?
Yeah, that don't make no sense. I should have smoked it, vape it, whatever.
Yeah.
Cook it.
They just passed it. It went into effect the first day or two, you know, far as medical and everything. But the thing is this, what people fail to realize, the smoking part is racial.
Yeah.
They won't admit that. But it's racial. Plus the point is it's a money grab also. Because as we know, when you do concentrates like that, it's very expensive. It's an expensive process. And then on the back end, as a patient, you pay even more money than you pay for flour.
Yeah. But see, the whole issue in that, though, is that it's like it's a monopoly in the power. So when you have the powers that be, like, it's just the same as any other industry, and that's part of where One Blood Radio was born at. If I knew, I had to find another avenue to make my way around this and make my mark in it, because this avenue is going to be saturated and it's going to be regulated to death. And if you're not part of the man at P, then you might be at the bottom of the boat.
Exactly. I mean, you had to get in on the ground floor, which I was happy when the thing went down with when we did Let's Talk Sports with Ivan Keith. And then I was, you know, I was let go right after me and you did that show that day. And I still thank them to this day, because if it wasn't for them letting me go, I'd have still been doing Let's Talk Sports and would never understood or knew the concept of what this plan is doing, or, you know, the rights, the laws, none of this. I'd have still been a smoker. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So the whole thing with me learning, coming on the show, you know, started doing the different states, and I'm going to be honest with you, it's like a high for me. I mean, learning all this information and sharing it with everybody, and you got to think about it. I know you had to remember many days I smiled doing some of those shows, because the point is this, I know we have people out there that still to this day is talking about One Blunt Radio, the shows we did, and how much they learned from them shows. So knowing that just by itself alone is great. And now that you're doing what you're doing out there on the coast with the Midday Burn, I do what I do on Rosemary's World of Cannabis, and now we have so many other shows that's out there. Me and you both done watched a whole bunch of stuff popped up since we started. I mean, you were first, and then I came next, and then it just, I mean, I watch a lot of these shows, you know, just to see. Some of them are pretty good, and some of them are pretty, you know, but I'm not knocking nobody's thunder, because everybody out there trying to get it. But it's nice to say that you are first to doing some things, and you continue to do it. Because I've seen a lot of people that jumped in this game, and they're no longer part of it. So you got to have a thick skin. You got to be able to, you know, you sink or swim.
Well, you know, like I said, I started, you know. The journey we've been on, we watched all the big guys and the little guys fall to the side, and we just keep chugging along, And God willing, we're just going to keep chugging along.
Yep, that's
it's
it.
It's something about what we're doing God agrees with.
And that's what I say, too.
Just kept them doors open.
Exactly. Exactly, because that's how I figured at this point, because if it wasn't, you know, if God hadn't touched this, you know, with us meeting like we did and doing everything we've done and the things we continue to do and we continue to piggyback and, you know, brand each other as much as we do, you know, one way or the other, you know, things like that just don't happen by circumstance, you know, and by all of us being veterans, you know, that's a plus. I mean, to me it is. Because that means that's a stronger bond and that, you know, you're not going to leave your battle buddy behind. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Definitely, because it's been a lot of years in the journey.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. So,
a lot of miles covered.
Yep. Hey, but check this out, though. I got a chance to talk to Rick about this on Thursday's show. We was hoping to catch you on Friday, but our schedules just didn't match. But we talked about everything. We talked about the Canada Olympics. He talked about you done did so much. That's why I'm stuck. The show, the marijuana show. I did not realize y'all. I know y'all did the first one. I did not realize y'all did the second show too.
Yeah.
For those who don't know, you want to tell them about the marijuana show.
The marijuana show was like the Shark Tank meets The Apprentice. And we did audition for that. We made it to the top eight. And that's basically you had to come in and show your business plan. They put you on like business type journey missions that you have to do stuff like, you know, like go out and make these tasks in business and bring this presentation back type of thing. But if you can make it through a win, got a deal with a mentor.
Wow, that's
cool. They just have to launch your business because they pretty much put the money up so you can launch it.
Mm. Wow, that's
cool. Jeffrey Peterson won season one. He does Cali Chronic Comics.
Mm-hmm.
And he actually does our comic with Blunt One. And our second edition is done. We just right now getting advertised together. We probably should have it out before long as
hmm.
So they can get that second edition, you know what I mean? But Volume 2 is coming, and if they checked out Blunt 1, then they would definitely like to check out the second edition.
Wow. Wow.
You and Urban Superhero.
Oh, wow. You just keep it going, man. I mean, dang. Okay, we done hit BET. We done hit that. And I know what we've been talking about for the past few years, Can Olympics. How did your last Can Olympics go out? Rick was telling us that y'all got winners from all over the country, and even in my home state of Florida, y'all got a winner from Florida.
Yes. Yes. We got winners. Man, we got people from all over that's been flying in and winning. We winner in Michigan, a winner out of Minnesota. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, Can Olympics, like I said, it makes its way to Las Vegas next weekend. And then I'm getting to see Hong Kong Olympic style.
Oh, that should be fun. Now, I've seen the beer pong.
Beer pong tournaments on the Comic Con in Vegas, so got a Lexus Park. Oh, hey, make sure you come down. I'll let your boy. I'll sign an autograph comic book for you.
Dang, that's all right there. You became a cartoon character. We always knew you was a character, but a cartoon character, man, really?
Oh, man. The whole team, Rick, it's like a five-man, it's almost like a super stoner version of Scooby-Doo because of the way the crew's built up.
Oh, wow. I can't wait. I'm going to have to check out a copy of that.
You're going to have to send you one out.
Yes, most definitely. I'm going to have to definitely check that out, man. Hey, dang, Bukush, I knew you were big, but dang, dude, you got a comic book, and here come BET, MTV. Wow. Hey, like I said before, man, I'm just blessings, man. Just blessings to you. I mean, we knew it was coming, you know, and like we all say, it takes time. You know, some of us can go up there quick, passing in a hurry. And then others, it just, you know, you just have to, like I was telling my guest that's going to be on the show next week, they call him Coach. and he's out of Atlanta, Georgia. Now you think I'm hype? Oh, you ain't wait. You gonna have to hear that show, man. That boy, woo! I'm talking about. I'm tired just talking to him. He's so hype, but he's so knowledgeable, and he has a great message that I can't wait for the people to share and listen to. I mean, this guy is on fire. You understand where I'm coming from?
That's dope.
Yeah, that is real dope. Yeah, so what else you got? I know you got...
Well, you know, at the end of the day, I do music.
Yeah, that's what I was going to talk about. What's your latest song?
I got three collabs about to come out. Okay. I got a collab with Swift for Show Shot.
What? Wait a minute. Hold on. Stop. You got one with Swift?
Yeah, and it's dope. It's dope as hell.
Oh, so you know you're going to come back on a different show when I do my Wake and Bake show. Where I can play them songs, because that's what I had to do. I had to divide them up into two. So we definitely gonna have to have you back where I can go ahead and premiere those songs on the Wake and Bake side of the show. Most definitely. So wow.
People gotta look at the song called "I Love Me Some Me." It's a big strong song. Whatever, I love me some me. Mm-hmm. And then I got another collab with MDZ out here, another big artist in the city.
Mm-hmm.
That's doing big things. It's called Perp.
Mm-hmm.
And it's coming out anytime soon.
Oh, wow. But
it's a smacker. Like, I'm delivering verses around town. But then, I got somebody on my single that I'm dropping, and he's actually from down your way. He's from, Tampa Bay. He's from Tampa Bay, Florida.
Okay.
His name was JT Money.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold up. JT Money?
That's
trying to
get up with my crew. That JT Money.
Dang.
And it's a swagger.
Man, I can't wait to share the... Hey, like I said, Wake and Bake is going to be a whole different animal, man. Sharing that type of music. Wow, that is deep. Yeah, hey, Kush, I'm going to have to bring you back when you release them songs, man. That's going to be an exclusive.
Most definitely.
Yeah, wow.
Quietly, people thought I wasn't recording, but I was just doing real quality work.
Well, yeah, you know, you've got some good work out there. I'm going to tell you my favorite is your country one that I like. I think
on this the best?
You know it. You know,
yeah.
That's my favorite.
She only
man.
Smoked the best.
Yes, indeed.
My man. She only smoked the best.
Yeah, because I mean, you would never think coming from you, you would have that country. I love all music, see? And for you to have that country twang that you have into it, man, it's just wonderful.
Hey, you know?
Yeah.
I got to tell you, if you listened to like 2 weeks ago on the Midday Bird,
mm-hmm.
I killed a country song. I think we're going to cut it out of there because it was just on the fly in the move, but it's fucking funny.
Oh, I'm going to have to... What show was it? I'm going to have to find that show.
It was like 2 weeks ago.
Okay. You remember the title that you
last
did on
week,
it?
Last week, I did All My Exes Live in Texas.
Ooh, did you modify it?
Yeah, I blocked that one too.
I'm gonna have to check those shows out, man. Shoot, I've been so busy with trying to get this up and going, and I just got so many irons in the fire. People don't fail to realize when we able to sit down and listen to other people's work. I mean, you literally have to carve out a few minutes, you know, because I know you be busy, I be busy, and everybody else in the industry be busy. So when we do finally get a chance to sit down and listen to each other's work, it's like, okay, yeah, I missed out on this, you know. But like I said, I just been, you know, by the time difference too, by the time I get to the time that you're going to come on air and a lot of you guys come on air, if I'm up, I'm having a bad insomnia night, and that's when I get to listen to y'all. And unfortunately, that's how I got to hear you that night, that I really couldn't get to sleep. And so I was listening to, oh God, what's the name? I listened to the Soul, what was the point of that? It's Soul Something. Soul Something out there that was on air. They had,
Solicit?
Huh?
Was it Soul Solicit?
Yes, it was. Matter of fact, they did Facebook Live, and I said hello to all the guys out there to let them know I'll be talking about them on the show. And I kept my word. I am talking about them on the show because they're talking about Bongathon. Man, that's what I want to talk to you about, because you were the first African-American to do Bongathon. And I was listening to the show, and I listened to the other show, and I wanted to talk to you about having that experience doing Bongathon. I'm going to tell you right now, when y'all went and I stayed back and did the Denver County Fair, I'm kind of glad, man. Y'all talking about the temperature changes and everything. First of all, I want you to tell everybody what Bongathon is about, first of all, and then tell them about your experiences out there.
Bongathon has been going for 34 years, technically, and this is a big smokeout. So basically, they have like the fastest grind. They're having the 10th dab out where everybody has 10. You got to smoke with 10, and just keep going to see the smoke best out of the race. You know what I'm saying? You got Team Bongathon. You got the big Alex Hooker. And if anybody knows me, I have the big Alex Hooker, and I have a Team Bongathon Bong. From being out there competing. I'm not just the artist, I have competed. I've done other things and competed. It's for real. These people train to do this. This is just like an athlete. They run and swim so their lungs are big and open so they can win this event. Like, that's, the glass is worth something. It's, the glass is a $2,000 piece of glass you win. It's a dope ass pipe.
Yeah, I mean, and when I seen that trophy that y'all had won, man, I was blown away. I mean, it's a huge event, and sound like from what I heard from the guys and, you know, the two conversations I heard, and it's kind of funny that I heard both of these conversations on the same night. That was so crazy, and that rarely ever happens that, you know, you were talking about Bongathon, and then their soul sessions were talking about Bongathon, but y'all was looking at it from different perspectives, and then you had a group that was from soul sessions on your show talking about Bongathon. I thought that was so cool.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, it's 4:20.
Oh, yeah. It's 4:20 where you at?
Yes, it is. It's 4:20. But you know, it's always 4:20.
Yes, I'm kissing
a cat. Hey, when we're together, it's always 4:20. You know that.
Yeah. I don't even, you know, I guess been in the industry so long, you don't even remember like 4:20 or 7:10, because you smoke all day.
I know.
Part of the day.
I know. That's one thing it took me getting used to once I came back here from Colorado. You know, when I'd be with different people and we decide to get together and smoke, you know, it'd be like, happy 4:20. I'm like, oh, it's 4:20? Oh, okay. They're like, well, what's up with you? You used to be excited. I'm like, look, people, let me tell you how my day started. My day started when I get up at 6 o'clock in the morning with my cup of coffee. I'm having 2 blunts. By the time I get ready to pick up my co-host, we're going to the studio. We done had 2 more blunts. By the time we get to the studio, we're going to be with Kush and Rick and everybody else. We're going to have a few more blunts. By that point, we done lost count of blunts for the day. I can guarantee you by the end of the day, we done had at least 20 blunts. So 4:20 don't mean anything to me no more.
And that's not counting the dabs.
No, that's not even counting the dabs. Oh, man, I tell you, like I said, hey, Freddie, this is one thing I think you remember. I hope you do. You remember the first time I ever did a dab? And we was out there at that event, out there at the Denver Market?
Yeah.
How in the hell did I get through that interview, man? I don't know. I couldn't even tell you. I think we were talking to Kush Collectibles, and that's it.
Your eyes got so wide. When you hit that dab, like, what in the fuck was that? And then he blew it out, and he was like, that was delicious, though.
Man, I was higher than a giraffe's ass. I had an out-of-body experience. It looked like I was looking down at myself. It was so funny. I mean, oh my goodness. We're going to take this quick break because the doggies are crying. Yeah, you tune to Rosemary's World of Cannabis. We're going to be right back with you. 710 Radio, iHeart Radio.
Are you feeling like a shadow of yourself? Is your mood on its way down? You could be suffering from low THC, also known as cannabinoid deficiency, caused by 77 years of government interference via prohibition. Do you live in a medical cannabis state or the District of Columbia? Are you over the age of 18 and seeking non-toxic natural health, well-being, and peace of mind? Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. After 10,000 years of recorded human use and 77 years of failed prohibition on the world's most extensively tested plant, the results are in. Cannabis has no known lethal dose and is arguably the safest and most comprehensive therapeutic substance known to man. Cannabis remained in the United States for pharmacopoeia until 1941, and cannabinoids are currently patented by the federal government as an anti-inflammatory. U.S. Patent 6630507. Human brains have cannabinoid receptors. Cannabinoids are lubricants in the human body. Due to prohibition, our bodies have been denied essential lubrication. Imagine never changing or adding to the oil in your car. The use of cannabis for low THC may cause immediate relief, including a general feeling of well-being, chronic smiling or laughing, feelings of euphoria, increased creativity or clarity, a greater appreciation for music and art, the desire to dance, increased feelings of inspiration, compassion or unity, a need for truth and justice, or you may wake feeling more well-rested than usual. It's undetermined to know exactly how many symptoms the use of cannabis may alleviate because of federal prohibition. There were dozens identified in the 1909 Eli Lilly Pharmaceutical Handbook. Currently, over 80% of the population supports the right to use cannabis therapeutically, and 92% of its users have declared significant non-toxic relief. The most common side effects, which are usually mild to moderate and may fade or disappear completely over time, are dry mouth and drowsiness. Other more serious side effects can include growing and repairing brain cells and DNA, or improve vision, may prevent Alzheimer's, dementia, glaucoma, nausea, and suicide, may provide relief from autism, asthma, anorexia, arthritis, AIDS, cancer, Crohn's, depression, epilepsy, fibromyalgia, gout, IBS, insomnia, MS, migraine, pain, Parkinson's, PTSD, and spasticity. Use caution while driving or doing other physical activities until you know how cannabis affects you. May cause paranoia or nervousness, specifically caused by real-life government intervention in your quest for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness in the USA. Ask your doctor if cannabis may be right for you. Brought to you as a public service announcement by The People's Plant, a campaign of conscience.
You know how we do about this time. Hey, got the doggies, did them day thing. Had to go ahead and take a pause for the calls. Y'all know y'all tired of that low pH THC commercial. I need sponsors. So until I can do that, that's the best I can do. Hey, Kush, we're back.
What's up?
Hey, we were talking about Bongathon, man.
Yes, we was. Bongathon. Like I said about the competition, but for me, Bongathon, I've been going for 8 years. And this will be my 8th year performing on the stage. Everybody knows I go on at 4 o'clock on Saturday. I got the 4:20 set. And everybody knows I'm going to get you high and do that shit.
Oh, man, I used to love when y'all did the performance and we would pass out blunts all through the audience and stuff. That was fun for me to see that and be a part of the One Blunt family and to do all the shows that we did together. That's something I'll never forget. I mean, just all the pictures, I sit back and I look at all those pictures and everything, and I think about, we did a lot, man. I mean, from the state capitol to the Colorado Springs, we were busy.
Well, you know, I mean, the whole thing about it was, if you have no stake in your own state, how can another state respond to you? So our goal and the whole mission was to travel all four corners of Colorado, performing and spreading the word. And through music, gave us the ability to spread the word. A lot of times, you might have got booked for music, and before you know it, we're educating people.
Exactly. And that's what was so unique about it, that, I mean, people would come out and, I mean, gave mad support. I mean, you packed it. Everywhere we went, we had a packed house. So, like I said, and everybody had a good time. And one thing I tell everybody, to all the events that we went to that was cannabis related, we never had any incidents of fighting or bickering or none of that. Everybody was happy. You know, happy, how you say it, happy, hungry, and sleepy?
Happy, hungry, sleepy.
I mean, wow, man. I mean, shoot. I just can sit back now and think about those events. And I tell you, the ones I used to love, the ones that we did at the Watering Bowl and the ones we did at the Speakeasy.
Yeah. Well, you know, Watering Bowl, we wrote history because we went to the Hollywood Towns just blowing the club out, just dab rings and smoke all over the Watering Bowl. Just, you know, had nobody did that in the club with liquor in.
Yeah.
And we did it really well for 6 months. So it was a bit long period before, you know, we got too big. We were packed on a Monday. Yep. Mondays was popping.
Man, we had Misty Mondays was off the chain because it was more than Misty. Misty should not have been. It should not have been called Misty Mondays. It should have been called Foggy Mondays because for all the smoke that we had rolling up out the bowl, man. I mean, it was a perfect setup. You could bring your pets out, your dogs. You could go out in the back and sit back and enjoy. We had, you know, performers coming in that was performing. I mean, you had food right there. I mean, it was the perfect setup.
Yes, it was. I mean, even got MSNBC coming there, you know?
Yeah, so, I remember that. I remember when MSNBC came out. That was showing off correct. You know what? I actually forgot about that, to be totally honest with you. I got pictures of all that craziness. I mean, everything, every event that we did, I have pictures of all that. So I'm going to have to go through Google. Google going to hate me because I'm going to have to go through and pull out some of those pictures and take a look at them. Because like I tell people, I said, you know, y'all guys always tease me about taking all those pictures. I said, this is history. And I said, we're going to go back and look on this. It's a lot of firsts that's going on. And I want to have this as memories. And I'm glad I did that. I'm glad I never put that camera down because now, you know, we're looking back 3 years later. We did a lot of things that nobody else was doing. A lot.
Right.
And we didn't realize. Yeah, we were groundbreakers and didn't realize it. And now sitting back. And, you know, I go to different events all across the country now and looking at what we did to what people are doing now, we're like, that's not going to work. And they're like, why? I'm like, we've done that before and you might want to do it this way. And people look at you like, how did you do that before? Who are you? And when you tell them who you are, they be like, really? It's been going on that long? I said, yeah. I said, just because everything is not seen on TV, it's a lot of stuff that going behind the scenes that you don't know about that's going on. Right. Everything is not publicized.
Right. That's why there's always a little slick room in the amendments just to try to throw you off. And then you look up and you go in there thinking it's a good bill and find out that they added some stuff at midnight.
Yep. Exactly. And that's why I tell people like this, don't take my word for it. Don't take Kush's word for it. You know, go look the information in yourself up. Google is a wonderful tool. All you got to put it in your state, whatever bill it is, and bam, everything about that bill pops up. Better yet, if you can't make it to the legislation house that day, go and go. They usually tape them. I mean, they have cameras in there where they're actually taping the sessions. Pull it up by your state and watch that. I mean, because for all the times I couldn't go to Columbia, I watched it at home. And was taking notes at home. So when I could go back, I could say, oh, hold up, wait a minute. So-and-so, you said da-da-da-da-da-da. And, you know, we got to fight the fight on every angle possible. And I always say, nobody's free until we're all free. And that's, and this, you know, and it's funny that I'm saying it now, for the fact is, I'm back to where I started from. I realized what freedom I had. And I'd give my left arm to get that freedom again. Because nobody knows how it feels until you actually lived there and was able to do your grocery shopping. You know, on your way home, you could go ahead and stop by the dispensary, pick up your edible or pick up your flower or pick up your vape pen that you need to make you well and ain't got to worry about the police tripping. I miss that. I ain't gonna lie. I miss that with a passion.
Yeah, and now they close at 10 o'clock.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I mean, you used to have to get off from work and rush to get there by 7 o'clock. I'm glad they're doing that. Man, I'm so glad they're doing that.
It's kind of funny last night to see 9 o'clock and the dispensary lights are all lit up. They're like, it doesn't even feel right now.
No, I can imagine not, considering. But yeah, that's a great thing to know. But Kush, man, I'm gonna get ready to wrap it up. And I thank you so much for granting me this interview today on your day off from work. I'm gonna have to say, Mr. Kush, besides James Brown, is one of the hardest working men I know in the business today.
Thank you. And as we leave out, I want y'all to get ready, because Dr. Kush got his own strain of weed getting genetically grown by Trico Shiidake.
Hold up, wait a minute. You talking about my Trico?
Yeah.
Oh, so I know that's
coming out.
Now, I'm gonna tell you like this here, Kush. When that strain come out, before it's even, you know, when it's getting in that final process, we're gonna have to talk again. I would have to make a personal trip there to try that strain, because if you haven't been in the Denver area and don't know Trico Shiidake, he worth the flight. I'm gonna tell you that right now. He worth you driving, getting on a plane, train, automobile. Do what you got to do to get some of Trico Shiidake. That's not hyping them up. That's just keeping it real. I'm only found one other pharmacy that I could use, or dispensary that I could use, that I ain't coughing. Trico Shiidake was the first one. I tell you like this here right now. I would turn over heaven and earth just to get a hold of Trico Shiidake's herb. That stuff is the bomb. You know, and I know people saying I'm hyping
check
it
me
up.
At OneBlowRadio.com.
Yep.
I remember SOS, Smoke Bro Fun. Oh, and you know I gotta say this.
What?
Gotta give shouts out to B-Dab.
Yes, indeed, man. Our brother from another mother. Hey, you know that was his dream for us to keep this going. And I told you I'd do it.
Amen.
Amen to that. Hey, B-Jams, we love you. We know you looking down, smiling upon Freddie right now. We know you looking down, smiling upon me. And we kept our word, man. We kept these shows going. And we going to keep them going. And we going to keep the memory of B-Jams going. No matter what I do, I always keep B-Jams in the back of my mind. Always. In everything I do. Because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be where I'm at right now. Amen. Amen. So you end your part of the session like you always do, and then I'm going to end like I do, because you know I miss your endings all the time, man.
Roll a joint, fill a blunt, do a dab or two or three. Do something for somebody other than your goddamn self. And so what?
Smoke one, son. Hey, I love you, Kush. We'll be talking real soon, man.
Love you too. Y'all have a good one, man. And y'all stay black and stay smoking and stay colorful.
Oh, you know we will. Love you. Bye now. Hey guys, if y'all don't know, you better ask somebody. We have been on the line with the doctor himself, Dr. DB Kush, man. You couldn't ask for a better interview than what I got today, man. The doctor has been doing this for a long time. He's out there in Denver, Colorado, keeping the fight alive for you and me and everybody else. Hey, like I said, One Blunt Radio, you have my heart, you have my respect, you have my love. And, hey, like I said, if it wasn't for One Blunt, 710, all these guys, you know, the main agency, everybody that, you know, jumps in and do what they do to help me to do what I do, it's all a team, man. We all got to come together as a team. Across the country, we had to reach from California all the way down to the panhandle of Florida. We need to reach out to each other and pull each other up for this plant, man. It's too many of us being locked down for this plant. And I'm saying it again, until we get up off our asses and do what we need to do, this is going to continue. We have rights. We don't use them rights. You need to find out what's going on in your legislature, in your county, state, and city governments. It starts there. And if you don't like the policies that they're putting down, guess what? Get together, find somebody that has the same like mind as you do, get them to run for office, or better yet, you run for office and get the job done. Because if we don't do it now, we'll never do it. I mean, we're so close. We are so close to winning the war on this plant. I mean, we got 29 states in the District of Columbia. Matter of fact, it's 30 states now, because Vegas is now on the map for recreational cannabis. You can have up to 1 ounce, but just don't get caught smoking. That fine is ridiculous. It's $600 if you get caught smoking out there in public. So don't do it. It's not worth it, because you think about it. Let me break it down to you in mathematical things. Okay, it's $600 if you get fined for this plant. That means you can buy two, four, it's not, it's a, you can buy an ounce up for $200. So if you can buy an ounce for $200, that's 3 ounces of weed you done gave them because you were stupid to smoke in public. Be sensible about what you do. I don't know if the hotels and motels allow you to smoke there from what it sounds like. Probably not, but it's going to be somebody that's going to be sneaky peek. I will find out who's letting you smoke. If you ain't got a buddy out there, just wait. Things going to settle down. The first couple of months of anywhere going recreational, they going to charge them high prices. They trying to make that money. Wait till it settles down a little bit and go. I would be going out in the fall months myself personally because it's going to be hot as hell out in Vegas. You know, it's the summer. It's hot. You know, they got that drought going on. So kind of let, you know. If you don't smoke weed before, so ain't no big rush to rush out to Vegas just to smoke. Say to be the one to be the first to smoke. I did it out in Colorado. It was cool, but at hindsight, me in 2020, the weed costed too much money. The cannabis costed too much money. So save your pennies. Go when it's cheaper. You have your good time, but once again, don't smoke in public. Whatever you do, so just keep that in mind. Okay, so hey guys, it's been a great show today. We're going to pull up something quick from the fight for my friends at Facebook.com, and we're going to end the show for you. How about that? Wow, this is a good one. I got a fact for you. I'm going to have to go ahead and do this then. Yeah, it's blurred lines time, guys, believe it or not. And these lines are definitely blurred. This is from my pages of Facebook on Facebook.com. One of my friends listed, in North Carolina, you can skip church and get drunk, but you can't treat your epileptic child with cannabis. Which is true. They just passed a bill not too long ago here where you can go ahead and up to, you used to couldn't buy an alcoholic drink till noon. Now they have passed a bill where you can go ahead and get your drink on at 10 a.m. But that's not as bad. ABC stores here in South Carolina and New York County open up at 7 a.m. But once again, we can't get medical cannabis to treat our epilepsy, our postpartum stress disorder, and our chronic ailments. Something's wrong with this problem, people. Big pharma, big alcohol is fighting. So, yeah, you got to get out and do something. So think about that the next time. Let's see what else they got. Oh, also, if you don't know, Crawford's. Oh, okay. This is a joke. Somebody's got a joke up about Crawford cigarettes. Okay, I was just going to say, I hadn't heard of that brand yet. Yeah, more and more. I mean, everybody's fuming right now about that that beer alcohol thing right now. So that's going to be a hot thing. But guys, like I said, until you get out there and say, hey, we've had enough. Oh, okay, here's one. I got one for the Washington Post for you guys, well, before we end this up. This is in D.C. politics. D.C. poses to give minorities preference for entering the medical marijuana industry. D.C. Councilmember Robin C. White, Democrat at large, in his swearing-in ceremony, sponsored legislation to give local minority-owned companies a preference when applying for licenses to operate medical marijuana businesses. Okay. This is the latest jurisdiction in drawing a nationwide effort to make sure minorities can profit from legal marijuana shades after decades of being dispersely prosecuted for using and selling the drug. We at D.C. government have an obligation to make sure that minorities and local small businesses can get on the ground floor and secure a piece of this foundation, said Councilmember Robert C. White Jr. Okay then, D.C. I'm going to be sharing, matter of fact, I'm sharing this right now on my page. I'm also going to be sharing it for Minorities for Medical Marijuana and South Carolina Edition. I'm also going to be sharing it on Miss Green Jean's page as well. Guys, I don't know about you, but I've enjoyed today's show. It was like having good times, old friends over again, getting behind the mic. I got to say, the doctor was a little tame. I was really surprised about that, but I do appreciate how he did his thing. The doctor does the thing the way he does it best, so it is what it is. So, guys, with that in mind, we're going to get ready to end the show today. And I'm going to say it like this here, guys. We already know. 30 states in the District of Columbia has passed marijuana legalization. Unfortunately, I live in one of those states that have not passed that law yet. and I have states bordering on both sides of me has not passed that law yet, and there's in the South. So there's a problem there. We're blaming and saying we want to protect the children, but what about the children that's sick with epilepsy? What about the children that's sick that has rare disorders that this plant would help? You're not protecting the children. You're hurting the children. You're not giving these children a chance to live their lives. And for adults, you're hurting your veterans. It is known that cannabis helps with post-traumatic stress disorders. You're helping with their pain management. Who wants to be on a whole bunch of pills that they can't have a quality of life for their family and yourself because they're zombified on a whole bunch of pharmaceuticals like Tylenol number 3, Percocet, and I could name the others. I'm not going to advertise for these people. So the next time that you get ready to go and do what you do, thank a vet for the freedom and pray to God that he's not post-traumatic stress disorder. Don't that he's got about ready to freak out, or she's ready to freak out because she can't get the plant he or she needs. But you say you think of it. That's a remarkable thought. All our legislators, our senators, our governors, and everybody else say they think of it. But we're sitting behind the lines looking out over across the other states that's moving on, that using this plant for medical reasons. And we're still here looking, saying, when is our time? When is we going to get this plant that's a healing plant, that's a helping plant, that helps men, women, and children? Ain't our kids worth it? Ain't our vets worth it? Ain't our mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers worth it? You tell me. And if your family member is sick, and you're in a member of House and the representatives and Congress or whatever, and I don't care what state you're in, and if you don't help pass a bill to do that, you're the lowest scum on the earth. If you don't move heaven and earth to help your family that can use this plant, you don't even need to be in office, because you're not doing yourself, your family, or nobody else no justice. Because by you helping your family, you'll be helping other families to pass this plant. I'm not calling nobody out. I'm just saying, if you don't help to pass the bill, you ain't worth it, man. I'm just going to keep it real. Because if it's my family member and I had a way of seeing it, if I could change the laws, I would do it. Matter of fact, that's what I do when I do these shows every day, when I get out and speak every day, when I go and talk to people every day. My goal is not to only help myself, it's to help others. And this is a therapy for me. So you keep that in mind. Hey, like DB said, roll one up, smoke it, do every how you do. Just make sure you medicate on the real. Hey, you've been tuned to Rosemary's World of Cannabis on 710 Radio, iHeart Radio, Rosemary's World of Cannabis. We're out, y'all.